gentlemen, the personality in expression is Mr. Lalit Kumar Jain, the president of CREDAI, who is also the founder and director of Kul Kumar Urban Development Limited. I invite him for his address.
Good morning. Honorable Minister Catalonia, Mr. John. Honorable Minister Kerala, Mr. Baby John. Mr. Muller, my colleagues on dais, esteemed guests, we have amongst us Minister of State, who is one of us, Mr. N.K. Sharma. Many dignitaries amongst us who head the real estate sector in government departments. I won't name each one of them, but we recognize your presence, sir, and friends. Friends, India. Sufalaya Sitalam, Satsya Samalam Mataram. The country of ample. The country of prosperity, country of peace. The heritage that we carry is great. We are in Catalonia. The heritage they carry is great. 2 years back, I was here on a study tour. And we were amazed. They took their heritage, they build on that. These people in authority supported cause of creation, cause of growth, and you see names like Gaudi and Kalatravas touching new highs and making their country proud. We are proud of this country, sir, and we have a lot to learn. 2 days back, I went on hop on, hop off, and I found there is a lot to be done here also. And we found that Sundays, the shops were closed. My 500 members would have given 500,000 euro business definitely within 1 day, sir. Issue is, you have 17% of unemployment, and we feel that the hard work that we carry with us, if we can improvise on the queues, long queues on your monuments, and if we can keep the retail open on Sundays, it will add to 15% of employment in that sector. It will definitely add 20% revenue at least, and this will definitely be of some use because European crisis has in some way hit us also. Friends, coming to our great country, 18 months back we started and we said we'll make a change, and we can. And mission transparency was launched. It culminated into enhancing acceptance level of developer community. I visited many states, almost all states except two, and last month I was in Kerala. We shared dais with honorable chief ministers of many states. And what we found? As we sensitize, the acceptance level goes up. As we talk about our frustration and we give solutions, they agree. So what was lacking or what is lacking even today is sensitizing the people in authority and making them work for a cause. And what is that cause? 24 million housing shortage in 2007, 27 million housing shortage in 2011, 36 million houses in shortage by 2025. And what we go through? A humiliating process of approval system, taxation system, so on and so forth. And then we are blamed for corruption. I have been saying this at the cost of repetition. We are victims of situation and not the beneficiaries. However, how long we can carry this cap of victimization? Don't we get offended? Don't we get frustrated? When do we call it a day? When do we actually say no to corruption? So we had a discussion in governing council. I had asked for a vote for whether we can take an oath that will not indulge into corruption, but a better way came out. The reforms can eliminate corruption. And what are those reforms? Very simple ones. Without costing government a dime, on the contrary, multiplying government's revenue, reducing cost of housing, and everything that is positive, but it's not happening. It's not happening the pace. I'm always a man in hurry. However, I'm very happy. A small city of Jhansi, Mangalore, and now I recently heard Honorable Chief Minister of Karnataka has said he will institute single window clearance. Many other states are already benefiting of better transparency like Gujarat. So, it's doable. What is lacking is sensitization. Today, I read newspapers, and because I'm also traveling and connected to you all almost daily basis, and I get pained with various news items which involves developers and portray developers in a very bad taste. I always feel that sometime we all together will really say, Ata Maji Satakli. Enough is enough. We need to now build up that. Can we just make these people who frustrate us and exploit us fear us? We'll make it. This is the time now that each one of you, 500 people sitting here, and my 10,000 members across the country, become ambassadors, ambassadors of change. Now enough education has happened. We have reached 100 million Indians. CREDAI has reached 100 million Indians through our CREDAI awards and various other media presence. In fact, the total media coverage during 18 months has been twice the previous 12 years. So we have reached masses. Now, sensitize them. And why? When we don't get approvals for 3 years, customer is paying 40% more. And you know, I've been talking about it, McKinsey says it, not me. When I pay 30% income tax and then invest in my house, I further pay 36% taxes. When I borrow, stamp duty, registration, other taxes are not calculated in my cost when I am buying a house. And I am given only 70% of the loan. So I have to contribute 45%. When FSI or FAR is only 1 or 1.2 or 2 in most of the cities in this country, the component loaded onto built up area is very high. And I have to travel tens of kilometers from my workplace to go home. It's frustrating. My cost of transportation and cost of living is very high. And for what? For inefficiencies? Developers do not get funding for land, and 90 days is the period when if he repays on 91st day, it's NPA. I am the sector which is contributing 75 paisa of every rupee invested to GDP. Then why? Globally, commercial real estate sector gets anywhere between 25 to 30% of entire credit. In US now in recession, the CRE sector funding has been 25% of their total credit book. In Brazil, it has been 22%. And what is in India? 2.8%. What frustration can we show when we see that the total home loan to GDP is 9% here, whereas global norm is 15 to 30%? Where are we? And in spite of all this, we grew at 30%. Imagine what will happen if these impediments, illogical impediments, are removed. Friends, there has been a great achievement of late. Now, because of our rigorous exercise with the Prime Minister and Honorable Finance Minister, and when we say that, look, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. There are precedents. In 1998 it happened. In 2008 it happened. That when housing sector was given support, the entire country's GDP accelerated. The steel, the cement, 265 types of industry get geared up. So, for the sake of this country, focus on this industry. Unfortunately, we have Urban Development Ministry and Housing Ministry, two separate ministries. Being member of Committee on Urbanization in Planning Commission, the first thing I emphasized on was club these two ministries first, and this was accepted. And Planning Commission has now proposed that these two ministries be clubbed. Then we said, look, there is nobody's benefit that Environment Ministry takes its own sweet time, Aviation Ministry takes its own sweet time, various state government departments, revenue, etc., take their own time. Who is benefiting? Nobody. And who is losing? Our poor consumer. For the sake of citizens of this country, to give them dignified accommodation, please do it. So now, the entire policy making personalities from Ministry of Housing, Chairman Hudko and various bankers came with us in Goa for 2 days. The subject was find solution to affordable housing. 2 days of intense brainstorming, some conclusions were drawn. The report which is published by HUPA, that is Housing and Poverty Urban Alleviation Ministry, covers everything that we conclude. That's an achievement. Then, what now we are saying? Committees after committees after committees. Now we are tired. Because there was one Vaidyanathan committee in 2002, said the same thing what we said now. There was another committee under stewardship of secretary then Ministry of Housing, which said single window clearance. So we are not wanting to reinvent the wheel. Please implement what is already there on record. and you will find that the 30% growth becomes maybe 60, 70, 80%, which is needed. Recently, and this is unfortunate aspect, some report submitted to Housing Ministry at the behest of Housing Ministry talks of 11 million houses unoccupied. I don't know when they were built. So, if such reports are accepted, how do we get the correct policies in place? So, we are contesting that. There is a lot to do. India needs $2.2 trillion of investment. If we have to bring our urbanization on track. And why urbanization? 720 million youngsters are aspiring. They need employment. They are migrating from rural to urban areas. And a philosopher said that poor people migrating from New York, Sao Paulo or Mumbai is a matter of celebration, because they are coming here to prosper. Let us make that a celebration. How? Providing them with the opportunity and the infrastructure. How? The biggest stakeholder, that is real estate developer, is supported well, given a level playing field and all impediments in his doing business are removed. Things will change. And this is what is CREDAI's agenda. Friends, Urban Development Department has issued a notification, again CREDAI's intense work, that FSI across the country has to be enhanced. Now, land being state subject, states have to do it. And what I found, there is no enough sensitization, lobbying is a bad word, on this issue. Please, for the God's sake, learn and let the knowledge disseminate to policymakers. We are in hurry. Our next generation, and I am very happy that amongst us this time, there are more younger people than previous conventions. And I am sure they are not going to buy the logic or the submission of their elders that SI chalta hai. This is what it is. Just carry on. No. We become the change agent. We sensitize, we advocate, we lobby, we pursue. And we say no. Have courage. Someday, if you don't show courage today, the people back home are frustrated. They will target you, target your community, and you'll regret then. So before that time comes, wake up. This is the time when we resolve that we'll be the most reputed, respected community in that country, real estate developer community. Are you in agreement? Yes. Friends, let's get involved in this mission. And that is the mission for you, your present. That is the mission for your future generation. And that is the mission for the country. If currently we are hovering around a GDP growth of 6, it can touch double digit and we will be the major contributor. Let every policymaker understand this and we all move forward with this mission. Friends, I will not read out the achievements during last 18 months. You have to tell what have we achieved. But now moving forward, we'll accelerate our pace, and every CREDAI member will do his bit, contribute to move forward. Jai Hind.